Okay. Wow, something bad happened there. Players dropped, I dropped. Who knows, are the internet gods against us today? Anyway, we're at minute 40. I'm gonna change the colors. So Tato is red again and Yo is blue again. Let's just hope the game will get in sync soon. Now that we had to catch up. And let me bring back the chat. Need to refresh, obviously. Okay. Game is still stuttering. We have not caught up yet. Oh boy, should really switch hosts after this game. Or maybe play on Wubly China, but there is something bad going on. Alright, the game looks better now. We have caught up with the players. Oh, and these eagles will raid this town center. What's going on in the front? Yo is building a good castle, like we've mentioned it. Should never give up control over this hill. Stone, two golds all around here. Could have even built the castle a bit further to the front, in my opinion. So that's quite a few kills, and this house here will go down rather quickly. 8 eagles, 9 plus 1 attack. These skirms are pretty useless now against eagles. Overall, the game is still very balanced. 125 against 135 population. The house was built here in the back to hold the eagles off. And now, War Traders coming in. They're not elite yet. Yo is getting a lot of upgrades right now. Tato is not. Both players are in Imperial, obviously. Villager count as well, 104 against 107. So the game is completely open still. A few forward buildings from Tato got destroyed. Not a big deal. I built a town center now at this gold. There's many golds in the center of the map. I like that a lot. So players have something to fight for. It's not like the extra golds are hidden in some corners behind the players. So this should force some action here. Two-handed swordsman upgrade now. And again, remember that these Celtic infantry units can run much faster. I mean, War Traders are crazy fast anyway, but even standard infantry cannot really keep up with eagles, but sooner or later they will catch them. This TC here, it went up now. Some villagers are inside, but yeah, these elite eagles have 4 plus 4 armor now, so they can sit under town centers all day. Jaguar warriors. Two siege workshops coming up. What is Tato gonna go for now? Maybe scorpions? I should reserve this trebuchet. Good fight. The Jaguars were still following the trebuchet, but yeah, they get a nice attack bonus against infantry. And only plus 2 here. Now, the champion upgrade has been finished, but still, plus 2 attack, plus 2 defense. Is Tato getting All these upgrades now, yeah, he's getting plate mail armor. Blast furnace coming in now for Yo and the Garland Wars. So this will give these elite Eagle Warriors plus 4 attack. So 2 plus 4, that's 6. And Aztecs get Blast Furnace as well, if I'm not mistaken. Military counts still similar, because Tato has some war traders running around here. This side here is still completely walled. Yep, it is. In front of his base, there is really not too much. Okay, some scorpions here, but can Tato afford the upgrade? I think it's 1,100 wood, 1,000 food, and he is rather far from that right now. More scorpions in his base. They're pretty good against Jaguar Warriors. They have no base armor, right? They have plus 4 now from the blacksmith upgrades, and they're rather slower. Eagles are pretty good against scorpions, but here against jaguars that could work. Ooh, this mangonel could reach the trebuchets. Come on, release a champion or two and get rid of this mangonel. One trebuchet down. Will he get it? Yeah, nice shot. This town center going down. Nice castle on a hill here. Near 2 golds in the center. Only this gold here is available at the moment. But it looks like Yo is reaching out for map control right now. And Tato is really forced back into his corner at the moment. He has a few villagers here. They're even idling. That's just a lumber camp, nothing special. Town center coming up here. I think he realizes that he needs to spread out, build all over the map, get the extra golds. But look at the blue dots on the minimap. Yo looks much better when it comes to map control. There's a gap here. Will Tato notice in time? Here, well, it's open, but there's a castle. Should really wall this. And heavy scorpion upgrade is done. Chemistry is done. Oh, 16 plus 1 attack. Oh, and the jaguars are going for the castle. They have 12 plus 8 attack now. So Blast Furnace has been researched as well. Garland Wars, Aztec infantry is really deadly. They can take out buildings in no time. That's not enough scorpions right now. Either needs double the amount of scorpions or a meat shield, like some units in the front. Like this, it's just not enough. Town center's down as well. And that's the downside of heavy scorpions, right? They're rather slow, cannot really chase the enemy, and yeah, GG called by Tato. Let's go through the achievements quickly. Yeah, Tato was even better in terms of food and wood. Gold, much better for Yo though. Yeah, Tato lost the control over the golds in the center. Stone also better. I don't know if Tato even was serious about going Vault Raiders. He would have mined more stone in that case, I guess. Huge difference in Imperial time here. Almost 10 minutes difference, right? And 4 relics captured. That's with the Aztecs bonus against none here for Tato. Okay, let's go back. Again, apologies for the drop. I have no idea what happened. It seems like one player dropped, so they had to restore. My internet went completely down from my ISP side, like the router just didn't get any internet signal anymore. So I restarted the router. Wait, the modem I meant. And then I restarted the modem, the router, and that worked, thankfully. Which takes like a minute if you go with both devices, 30 seconds. And now it seems to work again. So sorry for game one. We missed at least 10, 12 minutes game time there. But let's just keep our fingers crossed that the rest of the match will be just fine here. Okay, gonna update the score. That's the 1-0 for Yo. And yeah, now it's a home map for the loser. That would be Tato, who lost game one. What home map could Tato pick against Yo? I think Yo is not so much a fan of very, very open maps like Plains, Atacama, or a Desert Arabia. I think he likes Nomad. I think his water game is good, but again, he's in the a noble club of international top experts now, so he knows every map and knows how to play it. So yeah, it's a hard choice. Let's go to back. Let's go back to the game room. Less than 1 minute game time to go. You can see it there, 50 seconds now. Okay. Game number two between Tato and Yo here in the WSVG showdown stage with the last or the top 16 players. And the map is Baltic. Okay, so Tato feels like he could win this game here on a water map. We have seen Yo play water maps, Baltic, even many, many times. Maybe Tato thinks he has a slight edge over him. Let's see. Civilizations. Vikings for both, that is not a surprise. Yeah, let's check the map a little. This gold here. It's maybe a little close to the water, could be a problem in Castle Age at least. Secondary gold, stone looks fine, this stone looks fine. Deer can be pushed, it's not too far really. On this side, it's relics, extra stone, nothing special. Extra gold here and here. Then for Yo, main gold, perfect really on a flat surface, so I can town center it just how he likes. That is brilliant. Berries look fine. Wood is brilliant. This one here, far from the shore as well. I think overall, Tato has less space to build. Just look at the minimap here. That's huge area, rather, for Yo compared to Tato. In terms of fish, no big difference. Plenty of fish for both players. That looks all right. Okay. Standard build order so far. 6 on sheep, 4 on wood. Then you go for the first boar. Then you drop out a villager who will build a house for you, ideally near the shore. By the time he's finished with the house, you build your dock. Yada yada. I think these first few steps in water have not changed in 15 years or so. It was pretty much the same build order in 2000, basically 2001, 2002, and so on. Looks like you're... He's chasing the scout here. Dog just finished. Bringing back some shore fish, that is a fast way to gather resources. Same here for Yo, so the villagers don't come back empty-handed. Second boar in. Okay. Will Toto be able to click up soon? The goal is really to reach 500 food when you need it. Not at population 20, not at population 27, but I think including fishing ships it should be in population 25 or 26, depending on what you want to play. The scout will make it back, no problem. Also, we've seen variations with the fishing ships. I would usually go for 4 fishing ships. We've seen aggressive players who want to save that would spend it on something else. Okay, there's the loom. Now he garrisons 459. He just needs to garrison these shepherds and that's it. So population 24 with 3 fishing ships. That's a rather fast up time. He will be up before minute 10, 9:50. Now Yo is up with 1 villager more. Or did he just lose a villager? No, sorry. Ah, I got confused by the idle villagers. Never mind. 20 vills for both, 3 fishing ships for both. So they're both going up rather quickly. Not 1 extra villager, not 4 fishing ships. And here comes the second dock for Yo, probably. Dock already coming up for Toto there. 2 lumber camps, not a single villager remaining under the TC, right? The 2 fishing ships have to take care of that now. You want your fletching, you want your double bit axe. And you want to keep your town center going, obviously. Well, you need some food, so that's why fish is so crucial for higher level players, right? If the fish is really bad, or just far from your dock, then that could pose a problem, these tight build orders. Dock number 3 coming up. No third dock yet for Mr. Yo. Oh, can he lame the villager? Yeah, he has 3+2 attack now. The scout was a little bit injured, but the extra attack should help. Yep, there goes the villager. Sending in a new one, but this is always a good achievement there. He indirectly delayed the third dock, right? That was what the villager was waiting for here, enough wood to go for the third one. That gives him a slight advantage on the water. He was up quicker anyway. 3-2 situation right now. Four fishing ships in total now. Oops, and there goes the fishing for Tato. two galleys here. Tato has ships close. He lost one, and now he's sending them into the wrong direction, in my opinion. Tato had an advantage, and he had units near. Why didn't he just protect his fishing ships there? Anyway, so similar now in terms of fishing or income from fish, but I think in terms of military it looks a little better for Tato. That is 7 against 5 at the moment. And a transport ship. Did Tato see that? No, I don't think he did. Ah, he was so close. 1 or 2 tiles far. Here comes the transport ship. Is that only one villager for you? I guess so. So not a huge investment. Here's a scout from Tato. Wondering what he's doing in the corner right now. Is he just patrolling? Let's follow the transport. Or will they meet? Let's check Tato's point of view. Did he see anything or not? Oh, now he's turning around. It looks like he gave the scout multiple waypoints. Yep, and he saw it. He sees the villager. Oh, even the wolf might help now. There's 3 HP left, 16, and I think now with 15 the wolf will actually kill the villager. Tato can just run away and that's it. On the water, how does it look? I'm gonna go all sea for a moment. That is 15 warships against 10, so good advantage there for Tato. Yeah, Yellow is trying to snipe some reinforcements. And the docks will go down for Yellow. Doing a good job here. Lowering the number for Tato on the water. Ah, he's housed at population 40, he's building a house there with 3 villagers. Archery range coming up in his base. Is that just a preemptive measure here to defend? Is he expecting a landing from Tato already? Or does he want to transport over some archers? That could be an option too. Yo is on 100 food. He lost all the fishing. I don't see any fishing ships either for Tata, so he did not add any. What is this builder doing there? I'll keep an eye on this later. And now here's the visibly bigger navy for Tata, killing the last few ships from Yo. There's another transport ship. And archers coming up. Actually, Tato's map is quite wallable. He already walled this side. And if he connects this area and here, the forest towards the cliff, then it would be perfectly safe. He would have a very tight base, easy to protect. And that was the last chips for you. Can Tato even catch the transport ship on the water? He has something garrisoned in here. Transport ships move slightly faster than galleys, by the way, so it's easy to ship over some units, even if you get caught. 3 archers expecting them, 4 now. Where's Yo going now? Nope, don't change your direction. And that's it. That was another investment with no return for you over there. Unfortunately for him. There's the castle age now for Mr. Yo. Tato building an archery range. Market coming up. Yeah, he'll probably. Well, he took away his own chance to sell stone. He has 75 stone left. Yo did not build any stone walls, so let's go to his point of view. Oh, he still has 200 there, so he did not sell any resources. He didn't build a market at all. Never mind, he went for blacksmith and archery range. Usually the market is the normal thing to do on a water map. Okay, anyway. Castle age, let's say around 30% for Tato, and Yo is on 65. Nice use of the galleys here, controlling this dense area. On the other side, some archers. Oh, looks like he got a villager here. And he could, yep, shoot some villagers from behind the trees. That is 6 archers. Why does he let this dog stay there? Is he just hoping that Dio would waste another transport ship? I don't know. Town watch coming up, crossbow upgrade coming up. Now some fishing ships from Tato, I like that a lot. Yo, as far as I can see, is not trying to redock anywhere. So we will try to win something on land, which is not easy if you play against an opponent who has the advantage of a nice fish boom. Fish is obviously free, just need fishing ships and they collect food so quickly. Again, making use of the galleys. He actually doesn't need them anymore, but the best they can do for him now is control the sides, where the land gets really thin. Right. Ish says here 9-0, so this is just great for Tato. I would really bet that he will be up to Imperial quicker. Yo is booming quite well though. 2 extra town centers. Tato just getting the first extra TC now. He built a university quickly. I wonder why. Does he really want to go that aggressive now that he's hoping that ballistics would get him a nice advantage, or I don't know, because he doesn't have any army buildings forward. It takes him always ages to move over to Yo. Similar amount of archers, just fletching. Here there's plus 2, so Bodkin arrow research. Now there's the Bodkin for Yo as well. Oh, and no micro at all. He didn't even use patrol. If he had patrolled these archers, then they would have defended themselves at least, but he just sent them towards the north and Yo spotted them quicker. GG. For these archers at least. Alright. That was a small loss for Tato, but I'm still confident that he has the advantage. It is his game to lose, I think. Having water control, having a fish boom is usually so much worth on a map like Baltic. Okay, now there's a landing with 2 villagers. He's building even a dock at, well, Yo's shoreline. Maybe to reinforce, or I don't know. Anyway. box sounds like a nice idea. You're moving to the back, sending a lot of villagers to this wood here now. Padded archer armor coming up. These two vills are idling at the moment. And more archers moving forward. Slowly but steady. Manganel, let's see who gets a better shot this time. Careful. Still full HP on both mangonels. Yeah, we're going for this gold now. Villager count. I really don't know why Tato built this this university. Costing 200 wood. If he did get ballistics, then that's another 300 wood, 175 gold. He could have used for two town centers, roughly, or build extra farms, or do other nice things with it, more fishing ships, whatever. So now we see Yo having a villager advantage, who saw that he lost the water, so he invested everything he could in his economy on land. Oh, strange game here. Let's see if Yo can turn this around, push out of his area here. Ah, is he trying to redock? Good thing that Tato left one galley here at least. Osborman moving in. Probably does not know that there's a TC. Well, I think now is when ballistics comes into play. This crossbowman snipe villagers so easy now. You can see a destroyed mangonel from Yo here, so good job, Tato. Still four archers or so. Could be in danger. Yep, that was two. And not four yet, but will be. Let's see what's going on here. Nice micro, killing villagers and dodging the shots from the mangonel. Yo, though, got this mangonel castle coming up. And a very similar imperial time. Yo has around 30 villagers more, and still very similar imperial time for both players. Let me just compare. Yeah, that is 4 seconds difference. That's pretty much nothing. Siege workshop, rangers coming up, so it's gonna be rams, maybe onagers, definitely arbalests. The first player who will run out of gold will switch to skirms. Viking land army. It is not the greatest, but yeah, Vikings are so strong on water, you can't really pick any other civilization. That's just how it is. And Yo still has no chance of building new docks. Tato is doing a good job of controlling the shoreline. Another range coming up here. Siege workshop in the back. Does Tato have a castle at all? No. Not a single castle. 280 stone in the bank. Three relics, that is nice. Still, with trebuchets, it might be rather easy for Yo to clean up all the buildings here at the shore. Siege workshop coming up. Can he snipe the Mega now? Yes. Last second, but it worked. Lost three archers for nothing. And there's the first castle for Tato now. Trebuchet coming up. Is Yo building a trap in this one? No, he's researching conscription, so he really can't. And you wouldn't want to cancel conscription. Such an important upgrade. Capped Ram coming up. Chemistry coming up. The two-man saw, the third wood upgrade for Yo. And now these Arbalests will have a hard time against Capped Rams. We've seen a game yesterday with Slam against Togao in a 2v2 situation. So, after a while, it was clear that Togao's team would lose the water, and Togao switched his strategy immediately, pulled off a massive boom on land, and they won the game eventually. And we might see something similar here, because if you win the water, you control the shoreline, you get in all the fish, this is what the meta tells you to do, right? You should win the game, but I think Tato made some small mistakes here. The university and early ballistics didn't really do a lot for him. Yeah, the fishing he did well, and yeah, he didn't add extra TCs early enough, in my opinion. I mean, he's catching up, right? He's not stagnating. He's on 105 villagers, that is cool. But Yo was always in the lead, even 30 villagers lead earlier. And now all these forward buildings are gone, just because of the tech advantage on land. Siege Ram upgrade already done for Mr. Yo. Both castles here seem to have eliminated each other. Now Yo is pushing out. He has one mangonel. What to go for first? The Arbalest. Yeah, he has Rams here. Come on, get it. Yes, he got it. Another mangonel. Good shot. Oh, that's a fight with very little units right now. Tato wants to hold this ground here. Yo is only mining this extra gold here with one villager. But I think he set a gather point now. Yeah, we can see that. Good job. Cannon Galleon coming up. So Yo wants to make more use of his water control. But again, Yo has so much space. Imagine if Yo had the water control and Cannon Galleons, it would be over, right? Because Cannon Galleons can reach almost everything here. But for Yo, he can build in the back, and cannons can't really touch him. And Berserk's coming up. Oh, he even denied a castle here. Good job by Tato. And really not many units here. Can he deny the castle again? It's on 75%. Where are these villagers going? I could have started building here already. Yep, time to GB. 82 population. And he's trying to do the trick with a siege ram. Ships automatically always attack the nearest unit, and sea trams can soak up a lot of damage. And it works now, because Tato is not looking at the moment, and the castle goes up. This tricky worked for you. See on the other side? Yeah, he's still pushing. Onager upgrade done now for Tato. Fortified wall that might hold off the sea trams a little longer. Not much though, because sea trams are just so good against walls. Especially walls. Now the water is not gonna be big problem, but I wonder if Tato is making the right decisions when it comes to his upgrades. As I said earlier, that early ballistic, not a big fan of it. And now, cannon galleons with Yo having such a big chunk of land, that's a huge investment, and I wonder what he's gonna get from it. Maybe he wants to take out the castles that protect Yo's new docks, but it's not that many. It's gonna take a while for Mr. Yo to come back on the water, if ever, really. Another castle with docks popping up around it. Maybe cannon galleons are not too bad after all, but on land, does Tato have anything on land except for onagers to defend? Not really, not as far as I can see. Lots of thinking involved right now, because the players are not really in a rush. Yo has cleared his own area. Tato is obviously safe on his one. He still controls the water. Yo needs to think of something, and I think Tato should not forget that he needs to win the land as well. I'm gonna go to Tato's point of view, switch to the army view, and just watch out for land units. There is pretty much nothing, right? Monk, scout, an onager, and many, many galleons. That is nice for him, but Yo has probably more wood as well, so he really shouldn't go for a long game here. Yo will probably run out of wood later. Okay, so he destroyed this castle. He's bringing in sea trams now. This actually might be a very good combo against Vikings. Sea trams are backed up by galleons. It's not easy to stop because Vikings have just terrible cavalry, and Yo has not researched the onager upgrade, or has he? I don't think so. Let's go to Yo's point of view, check his gold, 400. Maybe let's take a look at the total resources collected. Just as I thought, about 5,500 more gold collected for Tato. This is what you get with map control. He's just bringing in all the extra gold he can. Let's go to the monastery. Yo has no relics at all, and Tato has 4, so that adds up as well. And there is the GG. Tato brought all his navy from the north down to this area now. Cannon galleons shooting at the castles. Still enough galleons left to fight Yo on the water, and You could have probably tried something on land, but he was probably well aware of the resources advantage for Tator. More gold, all the fish, really. So yeah, good time to call EG, I think. He did not draw out the game, even if it's a tournament game, and he has every right to try everything, right? Okay, let's go to the achievements. Okay, updating the scoreboard. This is the 1-1, and I'll get myself a co-caster. Just a second, guys. Tournament lobby. Okay, yeah. So this is game 9. And I'll move.
Channel switched. Channel switched. User was okay. Moved to your channel.
So sooner or later I will have a co-caster.
Good evening, Mr. G.
Ah, here he is. Hello, Doctor.
I am not 100% sure how long I will be able to stay, but I'm sure 1 or 2 games, maybe 3. But yeah, great, good game so far, and nice to be here.
Yep.
That was, I guess, one of the more interesting Baltic games just a moment ago, and I really enjoyed watching it, so.
Mm-hmm.
So many good games in general today.
Yeah, there was the Doubt game, and I don't even know the result. I had to leave when it was 2-2. Do you know it by any chance?
Yes, Lovcheng won the series 4-2, if I recall correctly.
Wow.
Yeah, it was very surprising. I mean, I know Lovcheng is a great player, but I kind of expected Doubt to take the series. And he didn't, I guess. It was some good games, some close games, but I overall feel like it was deserved. Lovcheng did play very aggressive and had a great execution. But also Doubt, he tried so hard, he tried so many things in the last game especially, and it was just too much.
Yep. Oh, question for our viewers on the stream. How is the